Okay, so let me share. So today we are working on a different what do you call one second. Just give me a second, yes. So just add screen recording and settings. Just a second, yeah, just give me a second. So you are able to see my PPTs? Are you able to see my PPTs? This one again. Can you just answer right now? Are you able to see the PPTs and back? And before you were able to see? Before, not now. Yeah, so just give me a second. We'll go for the sharing and then we will start. So meanwhile, every 15 minutes we'll have the break. Okay, so okay, sorry. So every 20 minutes somehow I'll come back to this question and we will just have a discussion about the question. Is that okay, or do you want me to have a half an hour discussion for each? After every half an hour you want to open up for the discussion session? Whichever way you are comfort, I would prefer to the, okay, 20 or 30. Okay, depending upon the discussion we'll see. Okay, right. So okay, 30 minutes, right, great. Now every 5 minutes will be very risky because today's session, we will be working on two topics, that is first Merzon, then we'll work on something called as picture. Do I need any prerequisites to understand this course? Not necessarily, but once the session is done, I request you to finish three topics by yourself, that is insertion sort, selection sort and bubble sort. These are not part of the syllabus, but you should go through these three sorting algorithms because they are very basic sorting algorithms, right? So what are these three? We'll just discuss when we start with the merge sort, right? But I'll be not talking in detail of these sorting techniques, right? So that should be, I hope it should be okay. Right, okay. So as I have mentioned here that we'll be talking about merge sort. Merge sort is one of the recurrent sorting technique, right? It's one of the recurrent sorting techniques which we will be learning in this session using the divide and conquer technologies, right? Okay, so before understanding this merge sort, should I need to understand any other topic, like should I need to know insertions or should I need to know about selections or should I need to know about bubble sort? No, you don't need to know about any of these topics, but you should have heard a term called recursion. This term we would have heard at the time of master theorem method when you were learning master theorem method, this word was being used. Or you would have heard about divide and conquer. At least if you have heard these terms, this is quite enough for understanding Mercer. Okay, so before we go to Mercer, can anyone Google what is the time complexity of insertion sort, selection sort and bubble sort? Since I cannot see your chart, I would assume that you would have gone, did a Google search and you would have gone the order time complexity as order of n square. If I am not wrong, you can correct me. Okay. So if you see the time complexity of a search algorithm that we were talking about, insertion, selection and bubble sort, is order of n square, which is a large time complexity because the growth rate is an exponential. As the input size increases, the time taken to perform sorting takes huge hours. Now the question comes with this. Okay. Let's say today's web applications, if you see most of the e-commerce gen use sorting as one of the features. Like you can sort the products by the brand, you can, that is search operator. You can sort the product by the price, you can sort the product in ascending or descending order, or you can see the products that are more popular. These are basically sorting. Now when you talk, when you see about a certain e-commerce, they claim that they have more than 1.2 million products or 1.2 crore products available in their website. Do you think if my sorting algorithm that I am using is order of n square, if I am using an order of n square, the time taken to load will be huge and the customer will really lose patience on the website and will move on. So I cannot use any of the algorithms which have time complexity order of n square. Now coming, so I should use a better algorithm. See, when we were discussing about the types of algorithms, do you people remember that we have discussed something called in-place algorithm, right? Stable algorithm. So we will be focusing on something called as in-place and stable first before we move to merge sort, right? Since I'm just moving back to the slide because I expect few people to answer this question, so I'm coming back to the WebEx here, right? Okay, now I have few questions for you. Okay, coming up, what is in place here? What is an in place and a stable algorithm? Okay, Anirudh is trying to say that, no, I'm not sharing slides now here. I just came back to the web. Okay, you are able to see the slides, right? Not right now. Just before a few minutes. I just came back to this. Oh, you are not able to see any of the slides? Okay, just give me a sec. Okay, just 1 second here. I'm sorry, like, I was just give me a second. Okay. Just one second. Just 1 second here, I'm sorry, like something needs to. Start broadcast. Sorry, I did my mistake. Okay, I got no mistake in this one. Okay. Now I expect, now we are able to see the screen PPT for a minute. Were you able to see the PPT for a minute? Okay, just one second. Okay, got it. Just one second. Now you are able to hear me? I hope now you are able to hear me? Yeah. So were you able to see the slides for a few seconds at least? Divide and conquer, no? Okay. Now I'll just go back and I'll see whether you're able to see it or okay. Now, were you able to see the slides? No, before few seconds. Okay. Just 1 second, right? Not allowing me to share. No, actually, I just. And all is done. So I'm just stopping the recording for a minute because this should actually help me to share, but somehow I'm not able to share, so just give me a second. I'm just stopping the record for a minute and I'm good. Stop the record, stop. So now, at least, so now we are able, so now we are able to see the PPTs. So you were able to see the PPTs few minutes. Okay, got it. So I'll just got it. So just 2 minutes. We'll start the session after I share. Okay. So I hope I am clear and the share also is working right now. Okay. So when we were talking about this merge sort, I have asked you that people should know about the divide and conquer techniques, right? So when we know this divide and conquer technology, this is a term which is very familiar to most of Indians, because Britishers have actually ruled our nation using this fundamental of divide and conquer. So now when I talked about the various insertion sorting, selection sorting and double sorting, I told you order of n squared is the time complexity, which is linear, which is exponentially as input grows, the time taken to sorting takes importance. Now for real time examples, if you take all the games that you play in your life, that is card games, the technique that you use is insertion sorting, right? And for coming of bubble sorting, the largest number, if you pour a Coke in a glass, the larger size bubble comes first to the top and so on, the remaining all keep on coming. So that's the simple fund of a bubble sort. What it does is, when I do iterative recursively, I try to always push the largest value in its appropriate position and I keep on running. But I'm not interested in algorithms of order of n squared, because as I have told you, this is not a real-time application. Now you know about in-place and stable sort. So the first kind of algorithm that we'll be seeing today is merge sort, which is not an in-place algorithm. What does it mean? It needs an extra space to do sorting. Okay. The next point. This algorithm's time complexity is order of n log n, which is way better than order of n squared. Now coming to that, it also works using divide and conquer methodology, which is a recursive approach to solve the problem. Now good. I think three statements I have made, that it uses it's not an in-place algorithm, but it's a stable, and the time complexity is order of n log n. And coming to the next, the most important thing is, it is going to use the divide and conquer methodology or the recursive method. Okay. Now, I hope people have worked hard for a lot of master theorem methods. Today, when we are analyzing the time complexity, we will be using the master theorem method. Right, okay. So let me start with the first method of divide and conquer. As I told you, this is a very famous technique that most of the Indians know, which was used by the British Raj to rule India, right? So the first is British Raj and next is to rule. How did they conquer the complete India? Since to solve the complete problem, it might be a very tough task, they decided that we will be breaking the problem into smaller parts and applying the same technique in the smaller piece, and once each piece is solved, then we try to merge them together to completely get the solution. This is what a divide and conquer technique uses. And as I told you, merge sort uses the divide and conquer technique. So I hope people were clear with understanding of divide and conquer. If you are having given a bigger size problem, break it into smaller pieces, try to solve each piece of the problem, and finally merge all the solution to get the global solution. And this is also one of the techniques most of the dynamic programming languages use with help of parallel computation. If you go for any parallel computation, you see that the larger problem is shared among the other core machines and the problem is done, right? So in most of the dynamic programming, we always start with merge sort and selection sort, because recursions are very important there, right? Okay. So now, who has actually invented the merge sort? I think if you remember the computer evolution, there was a famous computer called EDVAC, and which to solve the sorting problem in EDVAC, the first merge sort was introduced by John Newman. Okay, the year in which it was introduced is 1945, to solve the purpose of sorting in the EDVAC. Before that, the bubble selection and insertion sorting were the very famous, which were taken order of n squared. Okay, now I have made you that merge sort will take how much time? Order of n log n, which is way faster. This is comparatively which is faster than order of n squared, right? Now let's go to this algorithm. To work with this algorithm, the name merge, first we'll focus on merge, we'll not focus on sorting, okay? We are not working on sorting first. We are working first on merge here. Okay, so first when we work on merge, I will open up the form for the questions, because you have seen that going front and back is a little hectic process in this. So let me go back first, let me explain you the term merge, and then let me explain you the sorting. Okay, I hope everyone understands the term merge, merging of two arrays. What do you mean by this? Adding of two arrays. Now let's take a simple example. I have got a list L1 and list L2. Okay, list L1 and L2. If I say merging, okay, if I say merging as L1 plus L2, why should I use the word merge? Okay, I can use add of list, but I am not using add of list. Why I am not using add, why I am using merge, I'll explain you right. Then you will see L1 and L2. Let's see, when I am saying the merge, what was the output that I am using? Do my output is return something like 389157 or 157389? None of these are written as my output when I am writing merge of L1 and L2. What you could see here is, you are able to see a list because L1 is sorted list. Do you agree that L1 is a sorted list? L2 is a sorted list. There are two sorted lists. L1 and L2 both are sorted. Now when I am merging, I am finally getting an output of 1, 3, 5, 7, 8, 9. So this is a sorted output. When I say merge of two lists, which is none other than, I am trying to get an output which is in the form of sorted. Now my question, how would you like to merge two sorted lists here? What are the technique that are you doing here? Is it a compare based selection? Can anyone say yes, this is comparing the first two elements and I am trying to place the element in its appropriate position, yes or no? Can you agree with that term? I am saying I am trying to compare the list of elements in L1 and L2, first element to first element. Then I am trying to put the smallest in its appropriate position and increase the value at L2, and again I am comparing with the node L2 to L1. Okay, let's try it. So I am saying I am trying to do a comparison based merging. How do I do? Now let me write here little bit clearly before the time complexity. I have got 389 and I have got 157. Now let's take one more important thing. Are these two lists of arrays? Yes. Let's for a moment agree this is list 1 array. This is for a moment considered it is in a separate. Now I have created one more list which can store 6 elements. So where are I said I am going to compare these two, right? Now which is the smallest? 1 is 1, right, in the new list 1. Now can I increment this value to the next? Now compare between 5 and 3. The next smallest will be written. Next increment L1 pointer. Now 8, 5. 5 is smallest. Increment this. Now compare between 8 and 7. 7 is smallest. Now there is no need of comparison because L2 list is done. Now simply copy L1 list. Is this the algorithm that I can use in my merge sort? So I'm coming back to the questions, but with this respect, so I'm just I have to come back. So let me come back to the sorting. Okay. So now questions: is the merge sort, the merging of two lists is clear or not? Is merging of two lists is clear or not? Okay. No. Okay. It's clear for few. Okay, no for some. Okay. Yeah, Lamba, you have a very good question. Array size is different. Okay, Ravi has a very good question. Yes, clear. Okay, fine. Great. Now I have forgot to discuss about few things. So let me go back there, and we'll go back to the slides once again. Okay, let me go back to the slides. Okay, let me go back to the slides once again. I have missed few important topics, that is, okay. Let me discuss few things which are for. How is the list L1 and L2? Can you see, is the list L1 and L2 sorted list? I think yes. See, in a merging of two lists, what we did is when there are two sorted lists L1 and L2, we could merge. If they are not sorted, we cannot do merging. Okay, first important point. Now, once again, I'll repeat this with example of merge sort. Okay, so let me continue this portion. So I'll leave for a minute. I'll come back. Okay, let me show this particular portion in an animation. Now let's say we have got the original array. Something. Can you see the first original array which is unsorted, right? Unsorted. Okay. Somehow I could divide this list. So division. I could divide the list into X and the list into Y. Okay. List X. Okay. This is list X. This is list Y. Somehow. I'm not talking about how did it. And the division list is somehow being sorted. Okay, this is a, sorry, let me write this. This is somehow sorted. Okay, sorted. Somehow we have reached this point of sorted. Do not worry, how did we reach? That's the important of the algorithm. But I told you first we'll be working on merge portion. And then we will go to the sorting portion. I told you at the beginning. Now, if these are two sorted lists, can you merge them? Can you merge them if there are two sorted lists? Yes. Let's see how we will merge. And after this, I will come back to the questions. If there are still any questions, we will work on it. Right? Now, the one which I showed. Now, when I did merging, I told you I will be using the comparison-based approach. Now, initially, where are my pointers? If you see, in the list X, I have been pointing to the first position. In list Y, I have been pointing to the first position. Now, my result is to be stored. That is, the sorted list of the merging two elements should be stored in the result. So, let's see how we are going to do that. Okay. Which is the shortest in X and Y? It's 1. So, I placed 1 and in Y, I have incremented the pointer to its next L. Now, the comparison is happening between 3 and 5. Which element will be posted? 3 will be pushed into the result. Now, X, the pointer is incremented by 1 and it moved to 10. Now the comparison is happening between 5 and 10. So 5 is smaller. So the 5 will be pushed to the result. You can see 5 is pushed to the result. Now the increment has happened at Y. And at the X, the list is still pointed to 10. Now 10, 25, 10 will be moved to the result. Okay. Now again increment has happened at X. Now 23, 25, 23 will be moved to the result. Okay. Now after 23, I have incremented my pointer X to the next level, that is next node, that is 54. So 54, 25, 25 will come, okay, 25 will come. And next, out of 54, 74 comparison, 54 will happen. And whatever is left out, already Y is sorted, which I cannot compare with X, since this is empty. This is empty, right? Now there is nothing to compare. Now I can directly copy 75 to the list, to the final result, right? Can I do this? No. There are two questions someone had asked me. Sir, if the two divisions, that is X and Y, are not of the same size, for example, let's take X had 110 and initially here we have the 75 which moved to its position. Now what? Now directly this 75 and 100 can be copied into the list because these are sorted. When they are sorted, I don't have any issue. If they are unsorted, then I will have issue. Now I hope it is clear. So we'll not go to Sudoku for a minute. So we'll come to the question and answer session. So let's see what question and answers people have. Okay, so let's come back to the WebEx. Okay, so now let's see. Now I hope I'm clear. Divya, very good question here. Divya, in a merge sort, you have a very good thing, that is, if they are not sorted. See, in a merge sort, when you have this divide and conquer technique, the node X and Y will be sorted. How will be sorted? That I have to teach you. Don't worry. I have not taught you how they are going to be sorted. Okay, so one more question. We have a very valid and a very good question. Let's say after 75 I have got something called 65 value. Let's assume then the merging of two elements is not going to happen, because I told you to merge the X and Y. The most important condition is the list X and Y should be sorted. Now it's clear, if the value are even less, let's say instead of 75 to 65 and 75, after 50 both 65 and 75 will come and be placed at there. Okay, sorry, I went little fast. Let me repeat that once again, because I think I was little fast. For easier understanding, man, if I took a list of 8, 4 per division was easy. Okay, great. Two elements left. See, these all answers which you are asking, if I have two elements, how will the division happen? Left side one element, right side one element, then merge. See, merging concept, if I give you a sorted list of elements, can you merge? Is that clear or not? Just focus on that part. Is that clear or not? First answer. Yeah, it is clear. Now you have various questions. The first question is, if these two lengths are different, if these lengths are different, how will it work? I have already told you the solution. The X, all the elements are sorted. Y, all the elements are sorted. Till X and Y comparison can happen, it will happen, and the remaining elements will be copied. Right? I'm just talking about merge function. So one second, I missed someone's chat. One second. What if the array size is different? Yes, Lamba, that's what I am trying to say, you know. Okay, for Lamba, one example will just take. Okay. You are able to see my both devices, Lamba? I'm sorry. Okay. Right. See, if these two lengths are different, are same or different? Yeah. Now, but the elements that are stored in this array are sorted, right? Let's say these two are sorted. Now, how many I can compare? I can only compare my elements till this, right? Do you agree? Till this point only, my comparison is happening. Now, these elements are left out. Are these elements already sorted or not? Yes. Now, this I can copy in the new list. Can I copy in this list? Then they are sorted. Why? Your output is sorted. If, let's take in one more example. Now, if these all elements are smaller than this, let's say 1 to 10, 10 to 100, with this content. Okay? 1 to 10, 1 to 100. Yeah, the session is shared here. No, slides I have just come back. I'll go to the slides. No, audio is perfect here. Yeah? Okay, so let me, if this are less element, these are larger element, your pointer won't move from this. So all these elements will be kept and then this will be copied. So I think I'm clear. So yeah, I'm sharing the screen again. Then we will discuss the pseudocode, then we will talk about the time complexity, right? Okay. Okay. Right. So, I hope you are clear with till this point. Right. Till this you are clear. Now I have a question. What was the time complexity that you would have seen when you are merging both X and Y? The time complexity for this is order of n. How? I have list of x size in, I have list some elements in x array and there are some elements in y. Both of these elements are to be compiled and copied. So how many n's I have, those much time I am taking. So the time complexity of merge operation is order of n. Only merge operation. We are not talking about so. So let's work on the algorithm what we have written till the merging of two sorted lists into one single sorted tree. That's what we said. The two lists are already sorted. So let me finish this first and then we will go with it. Okay. See what I did, I have taken a merge function which needs to have a left list of elements. R stands for write of list of elements which are to be copied into an array called A. Got it? So that now ZL, which will be finding the length of elements in left array, and LR, which is going to find the list of elements in R. Now if you see already at the beginning, at the beginning of this graph, where are all the pointers located? Where are all the pointers located? I is equal to 0, j is equal to 0, k is equal to 0. If you see all the pointers are initially, all the pointers are pointed at the 0th level. That's what we are doing over here. If you see, that's what I did. All initially are pointed to the smallest element. At k we will be having at the 0th because it's an empty array. Right. Now, first of all, if the two elements have certain list, the two lists, if they have at least few elements, then only a comparison can be done. At least how many elements should I have? I should have one and one element. So that's why I should say, while j is less than the length of elements in left, and j is less than the elements in R, then only my comparison will happen. If j has reached to, let's say, 0 to 4, if j is at 5, there is no point for me to loop, going to this loop, directly I can copy the R elements, that is the while elements, into the final output list, right? So whatever, if the element in left is less than or equal to element in j, that is the element in the right side, I can simply push the left element into, see, I can push the left element into the result output and increment i's value. Is that clear? I hope that is clear. What I am doing here, let me draw and show you. Okay, what I did here, sorry. What I did. So I have got two lists. I have got two lists of elements. Okay, two arrays. One is L and one is R. Okay, and the other one is final result. Okay, somewhere result. Which I would like to name it as A. Now initially all my pointers are pointed here. Okay, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So assume this has got 9 element space. I am not drawing, but assume that you have got 9 element space. Now initially if you see, all these pointers are at the lowest value, L and R. This should contain certain elements. For the easy understanding, let's write 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay. 3, 6, 7, 8 and something called 9. Let's do it. Now what I did? Now initially I have seen that yes, these two have, so I can go to the while. I have entered into my while. Now what I am doing? We are comparing between the left element and the right element. Which is smaller? One is smaller. So I move 1, 2, 3 into the result output. A is result output. Now after that what I do, already 1 is moved, so I can increment my L's value. So I am doing, I is this pointer, right? This is I pointer, this is J pointer and this is K pointer. So I have incremented, so I plus plus, so my pointer is moved to 2 now. But at R, did I move? No. I am still at, my J is in its position. If L was small, L was greater than right, I would have incremented, pushed the right's output into the A and I would have incremented. So I am not doing anything. So this is just a portion of incrementing. This is a portion of comparison incrementing. Now there were few questions which you people have asked. Let's say somehow all my list is being compared and values have been filled. I am just doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now if this case is done, all the elements in L till this are done and all the elements in right are done till this point, right? Now what is the question you have is, I have to copy the left out elements either at left or right into the left out. So this case is what it is doing. If I is less than NL, just copy and increment. So I have copied, sorry, I just copied it. Right, I copied it. So that's what this loop is going to take in. Now I hope I am clear for how are you going to merge two lists of elements and the time taken is order of n. Okay, so I hope I am clear with this, the merging of two elements. So I'm coming back, so the recording will be paused for a minute, okay? So I'll just come back to see whether you have a question, but immediately I'll move to this particular slide, okay? Just give me a second. So, okay. Okay, now are there any questions? How was the merge operation happening? Okay, see if X had, okay. See if someone has a very valid question, so let me go. Can you please explain how we got, one second. Cancel. Someone has a really valid question. Let me see. Okay. I have already explained, you know, the size of difference. So any other new questions if you have, I can just discuss. Okay, so I think people have no questions, so let me okay. One second. Okay, so there were few questions, so let me answer them directly. So one of the question one of your friend has is a very valid question, says that if values are unsorted at X and Y, we cannot do merge yet. The algorithm what we have till now discussed is merging of two lists of sorted elements. So definitely the elements at X and the elements at Y should be sorted. Right, so let me finish this, and once we are done, we will have the question. Okay, now the biggest funda till now what you have seen is you have seen a list of X sorted and a list of Y sorted. Right, now the question is initially the input that is given is an unsorted list of elements. So, for example, if you take this is an unsorted list of elements, that is 37, 23, 6, 89, 15, 12, 2, 19. These are unsorted. Now, unsorted list. But what we did, what we have learned is we have missed some of the important steps here, and we concluded if somehow I get a list, two lists X and Y that are in sorted orders. So, four elements I'm just taking up, I'm just doing this division over here for easier understand. So, let's say 6. 23, 37 and 89, then somehow 2, 12, 15 and 19. Somehow if X and Y we have been given, I am able to give you the sorted merge list. That is what I have learned, right? Sorted merge list. But there is a major algorithm which is to be learned in between this steps, right? This whole algorithm we have not learned. Now let's see how the list, how the original list is being divided into two sorted lists. That's very important for us now. Now, one more important question. Is this being done in the same place? Like, is it using the same array? No. Here we are using an extra memory of array to perform these operations. We are copying into different arrays. Okay? So that's why I have told you merge sort is not an in-place algorithm. Most of, if you refer any of this textbook, the space complexity of merge sort is order of n, someone write, or somewhere it will be written as order of n log n. This we will discuss at the end. This is space complexity. Space complexity. Why is this? We will just stop at the end. Right? Now, how I am going to make sure that I have got two sorted lists of arrays when there is a given input in one single array. Now let's see first. Okay, I have few questions. The first important question I would discuss here is, can you say that a single element is always sorted? Can you agree with the word a single sorted element or a single element is always sorted? Will you agree with this term or no? Will you agree with this term? I hope yes. Let's take an example. I have got 2 as my list. Will you say this is a sorted element? Yes or no? Okay, good. Now if I give you one more single element as 1, 2 is sorted, 1 is sorted. Do you agree with these terms that 2 is sorted, 1 is sorted? Now if let's say X list is 2, Y list is 1. Can you merge these two? Yes. Because we have learned the merging of 2 sorted lists. What will be your output? 1 copy, okay, then copy 2, right? This is what you have learned. Now, the merge sorting algorithm works here with divide and conquer in a fashion of dividing the list in 2 till you get 1 single element. Now, let's see the algorithm. Okay, this is the list given as unsorted. If I have to divide this list into equal parts, can I do n by 2? See, you have freedom to use floor or ceiling. Okay, preferably always we prefer to use the floor function here. Why? Because it is not necessary always you should have the length of array as even. If it is odd, then you can't divide at equal parts. That's why we prefer to use the floor function, so that in the first list you can break it into some even numbers, and in the second list you can have some odd numbers. See, if I have divided, is these two sets clear? I have divided it as n by 2. You are okay? Yes, I agree that I just simply divided using. So I have new list. So I'll write new left, new right. I'm clear? Okay. Now can I further this list? Can I further divide this list? Yes. I can divide this into 2 halves. Again, I did the same thing at the both ends. Can still I divide it into further division? Yes, I can do till this part division. Now, what I have got here, in this particular line, if you see, I have got a single elements. Single elements in array, each array. Now each element is sorted, 98 is sorted, 23 is sorted, 45 is sorted, 14, 6, 20, 67, 33, 42. All these elements are sorted. Now when these elements are sorted, now what technique did I have learned till now? Merging. Can I merge these two? Can I merge 23 and 98? Can I do that? If I merge, this list is sorted. Let's see. 45, 14. Yes, this is sorted. 6, 67. Yes, this is sorted. 33, 42. Yes, this is sorted. Now, again, I can merge these two. I have got 14, 23, 45, 98, 6, 33, 42. Again, I can merge these two to get a sorted list. So, what will be my sorted list? 6, 14, 23, 33, 42, 45, and 67. Do you agree with this? I think I have gone a little bit fast. So let's see this in a graphical method, and if still we have not understood, we will repeat the session. Do you want me to take a break? Yes, we will go for a small break. Just give me a second. We'll go for a break, and I'll also on my chartboard in a different PC so that I can view your questions. Right? Let me just stop. So we are going for a break for 5 minutes, so we'll meet exactly at, it's not 5, it's 8 minutes, we'll meet at 12 o'clock, right? Okay. I'm just stopping the broadcast, so let's see. So, I'm coming back to the question and answer session, so if you have a question, let's see. Okay, so please post the questions right now, yes, because I could not see what questions you had. So after the break, do you want to have questions or now you want to have the questions? So no questions. So we'll have the questions after the break. Yeah, I told you midterm results will take certain time. So you are keep on asking me about the midterm, so it will be really tough for me. It will take at least 30 days here. Any other question? Yeah, after break. Go ahead, yeah. So meanwhile, I'll also try to... I'm sorry, like we'll go for break, and I've also opened the desktop next to me so that I can read the question, what you are asking, and I will try to answer them, and we will keep this session recorded lively, right? Okay, good. Yeah. See, if there is an issue with the recording, I'll re-record this session, okay, and I'll upload so that you don't have any issue in learning. Okay, that's why I'm trying with one sort, that is merge sort. Yeah. Okay, yes. So let me reshare the content. Okay, so I think I'm audible right now to everyone. Yeah? Hopefully I'm getting some resound. Just one second. So you're able to hear me? So I'm audible. Yeah, okay. So let's start working on it. So since I promised you that I will be able to see your chat now, so I have made that arrangement so that I don't need to stop my recording. I can view your chat from my other system and I'll be able to answer your question. So hope you are clear with the merging of a two sorted list, right? That I think you were pretty clear with that. So now we will see how I'm going to do the sorting technique, this merge sorting, when you have been given an unlisted list of unsorted elements. See, here I'm going to use a basic funda of called divide and conquer. So what is that I'm dividing is, in a given list, I'm dividing the list till I encounter a single element. If you see here, I have clearly done that till this portion. So I have only divided, I have done nothing. Once the division is done, when I encountered single elements in the list, told these elements are sorted elements. Now then I started using the merge function, right? Did I started using the merge function or not? Yes, I have started using the merge function. When I started using this merge function, I have been able to get the list, sorted list, in the form of merging. And finally, I was able to do this set. Sangeeta, what is no? You are not able to hear me? I think people have not come the I think people have not come from the break yet. I'm sorry, I started little early. Okay. Can I restart this? Okay, I like to restart this. I'm sorry. I think I just moved ahead. Yeah, I'll definitely take Nitesh Gupta. Don't worry. Okay, first let me try to understand whether you have understood the merge or not. Right? Okay. Now I have a question for you. If the last list, this list, can you apply merging on this? Merge and get a sorted list. Can you get that?
Yes.
Okay. Till this portion you are clear. This last step you are clear. Okay. Good. If you are clear with this, then I think the half of our algorithm is done. Don't worry. Okay. Now what we have done, if you see, is I have been given a list of unsorted. Do you agree this is an unsorted list? Sorry. This is unsorted. Would you consider this as unsorted? Yeah. Will you consider this as unsorted? Yes. Definitely would have considered this as to be unsorted. Now, the dividing function which I am using here is trying to break the list into halves. Now, the question is, as one of my friends had asked, if the list which I have given here is an even list. So, when I do division, n by 2, I get 4 and 4, right? 4 and 2. But if it is an even, or if it is an odd, what will happen is my division, that's why I use n by 2 to the flow. So I get 4 and in the other list I get 5. That I will show you in the algorithm how I have taken it. So the division here, we are just trying to identify the mid location. It's not, we are just trying to identify a point which is 4. Okay? All the elements less than this should be in the left array and all the elements greater than this point should be in the right array. That's all. And remember, always we are copying into new list of array. This is copied. These elements are copied into new list of array. Always we copy. We copy into new list of array these elements. Okay? These left elements are copied into new list of array. Okay. So I am continuously dividing. Sorry. I am continuously dividing the list of elements all the way till I get single element. Now when I get single element, what I can say? I can say the single element is a sorted. When I give you two single elements, can you merge them? If I give you two single elements, let's say 98 and 23, can you merge them? Yes. If this is here, if you see, I am using the merge recursively. The merge, what we have learned, I am using recursively all these parts. Okay. So let's see. Let's go to algorithm. So algorithm is in the next page itself. So so instead of seeing the algorithm right now, trying to understand the algorithm right now, do you want me to go to the graphical implementation of this example and come back to the algorithm? Which one would you like? Can we discuss about the algorithm for a moment? I'll go first. Great. Okay. I'll just use something simple word. I think merge sort on left, merge sort on right, and merge left right. Have we seen merge on left right A? Merge left right A. Have we discussed about this? Yeah. What is the time complexity of that particular portion that we discussed? Yeah, great. Order of, yeah, good. So this we will talk about time complexity at later, but you understood its order of it. Great. Mayank, no, we will not have any. Mayank, you have very valid question. Can we divide up to one single and one two element array? No, you cannot do that. You will be dividing it to single element only. Now, your question is something like this. Let's say I have got a list of 1, 2, 3. Okay? This is your question. 1, 2, 3. Now we are saying, can I have the divide and conquer till this portion, right? Is that your question? 2, 3. Is that what you were asking? No. Still, here I am not sure whether this 2 and 3 are sorted. Technically, let's take one more better example, 3 and 2. Okay, this is 3 and 2. Now I cannot use merge function. When I use merge function, 3 and 2 are unsorted. Okay, one second. Let me finish. So that's why we try to always, okay, divide till single. Right? Okay? And then we try to do the merge operation. Okay. Now one fellow has a very good question. I'm sorry if I'm using the word fellow. Fellow is not in terms of humiliating, it's just in terms of addressing. Yeah, I'm sorry. So one of your friend has this following question. Let's say my list has got 1, 2, 3 and 2. Okay, this are the repetition of elements, right? This is the question that you have asked. Is this the question that you have asked or anything else or you wanted me to ask? So now what happens is, since it is a stable source, what happens is the elements that merge also are in the same order. Okay, so it's a stable sort, so the first two what you see after 1 is inserted. 1, so your order will be after sorting 1, 2, 2 and 3. Okay, 1, 2, 2 and 3. Mayank, I'm not able to get your question here. Mayank, I'm not able to understand. Merge 1 and 32. We get merge combining list. Okay. See, what happens is 3 and 2 are not, see, they are not sorted. So I cannot use merge. When I'm using merge, condition is there should be a sorted list. That's why we try to divide 3 and 2 into single elements, then we merge, then you get 2, 3 in the merge order. Got it? Okay. So let's have the discussion on the algorithm of merge sort completely. Okay. Now what we have did is, first of all, I should see whether I have got certain elements to do merge sort. Now one important question. If I have got a single element in my complete list, do I need to do any sorting techniques for that? If I have got, did I got into mute? No. Nitish, I am not in mute. If you are not able to, okay, voice is getting bricked. Okay, I think that's an internet issue. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Now I have few questions. Let's try to ask certain questions. Then we will try to work on it. Okay. I think the internet got little slow here. Why? Because I'll go back and come once again. Because the change is not happening quickly. Yeah. Now it's fine. I think now internet is working good. Yeah. That's what. See, I'm also cross-checking in other machines. That's why I could see what are the issues that you are trying to face. See, I can't keep it in mute. I have to mute it. Otherwise, there will be a question. Perfect. Let's discuss about it. Now I have a question for you guys. Let's say if I've got one single element in my array, do I have to need to any sorting at all? Or no? Why not? No, Jolly. You answered first, so I asked you. Why not? No. Why not? No. Because no, it's not about comparison. Always a single element is a sorted element. You are alone, you can define yourself as queen, you can say you are a soldier, you can say yourself as a colonel, any, because no one is there to compare. So if you are alone, it is considered as always the sorted element. So first of all, I should know the length of elements in my array. So that's what I am doing with length of n. After I understood the length of array, after I have done the length of array, what I am trying to do? I am trying to see if the length is greater than 2. If the length is at least greater than 2, I have to do the division. If not, I don't need to do. Yes or no? Yes or no? If I have got only one single element, can I divide a single element into... If I have got a list of elements with 1, can I divide the list? No. So that's what I am trying to do here. If the list is less than n, I'm simply returning. What it means, I'm not performing any sorting algorithm. Yes, if it is single element, I don't need to do any sort at all. So I have to return. If the list is greater than 2 elements, definitely I have to identify the mid location to divide. Once I have identified the mid location, see, when you are identifying, for example, in this case, you will have a question. Let's say my list is 1, 3, 2. When I do mid, let's say the total n is equal to 3, 3 by 2, when I do, I get 1.5. So should I do the floor or ceiling? That is up to you. Generally, floor I do. So I'll say 2 elements. So the position, that the element that is at 2 from there our division starts. So say, let's say if you do floor, it will say the position 1, whichever element is at 1 should be copied. So that's what I have identified from where the elements to be. So I copy all the elements from mid to starting to mid to the left end, the rest all to the right. Okay, got it? This function of left. Same here, if you have 13 values, what are the total value? 13 by 2 kitna hai, Ranjan? 13 by 2 is something like 6.5, right? Yes or no? Yeah. So you cannot do a division at 6.5. Either you have to do the division at the element that is located at 6th array position or 7th array position, right? You have to do either. Yes. So definitely that's why you can use a floor function. If you use floor function, your division will happen to 6. So all the elements starting from 0 to 6 will be in the left array, and all the elements from 7 to, okay, 7 to the last will be in the right array. Got it? 7 to whatever your last element. Got it? That's what I'm doing. So left all the elements till mid, and all the elements after mid are copied at the right array. Is it this clear? Is this clear or not? Yeah. So right? So that's what we did in the beneath. If you see, all the elements should be at left and right. Now I have to copy them into new array. I have to always copy them into new array. So what I'm doing, from i0 to mid minus 1, I am copying into the left of I of E of I. And similarly, I am copying, these two for loops are trying to create the auxiliary condition and copying the values into the new array. Got it? You have got it? Now if you see recursively, yes, you got it. So simply I have identified there should be some left and right, and then I copied it into the new auxiliary arrays. The for loop is used to copy the elements in the new auxiliary. After that, what happened? Till now, can anyone just say me what happened till now? Now, till now, what I did, I'm just showing you with the help of a graph, with the help of this animation. One second, I'll come back, Moni. Just for a minute, what till I have did? I have identified the mid, okay? I have done the division. And these, the two of these things are copied. Yes, I just copied them into the two new auxiliary arrays. Is that clear? Till now what I did? Till now what I have done is clear? Just identify the mid location, copied them into the two different left and right. Okay, now get it. Now, is this, these are the sorted list? Did I got any sorted list here? No. So what should I do again? Now, Divya, since you have answered me that no. Now just let me say, what should I do again? What should I do again? Divide again. Nitish, you are correct. Yes, again divide on the left element and again divide on the right element. Yes or no? Do I am correct? Yes. Yes, I have to divide on the left list and divide on the right list. So if you see my pseudocode, one second, it's taking time to go back. Now, what I'm doing, merge sort on the left, merge sort on the right. I'm doing this. What you said is to repeat this. This is recursively of division and copying into new array. Yes or no? Recursively, I have to divide and copy it. Yes or no? Yes. Now, that's what, as you have suggested me to copy, to repeat, okay, as you have suggested me to apply the recursion division on the left and right, sorry, it's taking 1 second, yeah. Now, did I apply it on my left side? Yes or no? Yeah. So again, I can divide completely on my left. This is how it is working here, okay? Now, till now, this is, you agree till now? Yeah, Vinod, we'll work on pseudocode. Don't worry, Vinod. Just give me a second. Okay? Till now, this is perfect. We have done division. Now, what I should do? What should I do now again? Should I merge? Yeah. So, let's see the pseudocode once again. Let me show you the pseudocode once again. Yeah. 1 second. So I am doing the merge operation on the left and right. Yes, and I'm storing it on a duo. I am doing it recursively again and again. Yes or no? Okay. Now let me ask you certain question. Is the pseudocode clear or you have any issues? Yeah, Nitish, go ahead. Not clear. Great. Don't worry. I'm here to clarify. Don't worry. Okay. Once again, we know that Nitish. I understood. I did not understand that. Okay. Okay. Great. Merge right. Great. Okay. Any other questions? Maybe. No, you're just out from. I'll just talk about it for a minute. Okay, loop. Okay, great. Okay, anything else? Okay, good. Now, if you see your questions, I'll say. I think you are clear till this part. Till this part. Okay, let me clear all this thing first here. Let me clear. Let me clear this card. Okay. Now this is clear, I think so. Now it's clear. Okay. So I'll ask step by step. Merge sort is clear. The last step of merge sort is clear. Merging, sorry, not merge. Merging of left and right is clear. Yeah. Okay. So I'll not talk about this one. Okay. Now we have only question like merge sorting of a list of elements. Okay, this I'll show you with PPTs again just for a minute. Finding out the length of array. I hope this step is clear. Yeah, okay. If you have elements less than 2, I don't need to run any sorting algorithm. So that is what my second step is doing. If I have elements less than 2, do I need to run a merge sort? No. So I have discard. Now, when the elements are greater than 2, I should know where my division of the list should happen. That is taken care by mid of n by 2, right? I'm just trying to take care. If I have got elements less than greater than 2, I should divide at some point, and that point is identified by mid of n by 2, where you can use floor or seat according to the user's choice. Clear? That till that it's clear. Now next question. Now all the elements in less than the mid value and all the elements greater than mid value should be stored in the left and right. That is what I'm saying. Right? Should be stored at the left and right. So that storing function is being done by this one. Is that clear? So I am trying to move all the elements that are in the left side into new auxiliary array, because I told you this algorithm uses extra space. That extra space is auxiliary. So yes, first element of right, one second Raja. So the first element of right array is mid. Yes, correct. So the first element of right array is the middle. So you are copying all the elements till the mid from the left into the new auxiliary array. This is taking care. All the elements in the right list are being moved to the new auxiliary array list. Right? These are two new arrays. Okay. Till that it's clear now? Yes. Yes. First 5 steps. Correct, Vinod. Got it. So first 5 steps are taking care of breaking. But what happens is this is one loop. Just one step of breaking the complete list. One breaking has happened. Only one break. After that, what you have two lists. Now, your mechanism, what it will work is, it will start working on the left portion. Okay, left portion. Now, we will see these last three steps with animation. Is that okay? If I show you these three steps with animation, I think it will be much easier for you. Right? Okay, let's go to the animation portion. Now, if you see, this is the first list that is being given. So I will say the first 5 steps are dividing steps, okay, for easier understanding. Merge left, merge right, merge sort left, merge sort right. We will just discuss, and then we will discuss about merge of left, right and array. Okay, so I think you have been not got an exam. Now it's clear. Now what is that I have to divide? Is this the division is done and it is copying is done. Now, when you go back to the list, let's say, one second. No, it's better I exit this presentation for a minute so that it is This card, okay. Is this one second? One second. It's taking some time. Okay. Now, if you see, till this, what we did, we just divided into two lists. That's what we have done here. Okay. Till now, this has happened. Now, if you have seen clearly in the algorithm, after this step, what is that? The loops have been written. Merge sort left, merge sort right, merge of left comma right comma A. Yes or no? If you have seen, do you want me to go back to the pseudocode slide once again? See the pseudocode, till this portion we have done this division. After that, if you see, you have something called merge sort left, merge sort right, and then you have called merge left comma right comma A. So now if you see, the next step what we are doing is merge sort on left. What is the left element that you can see here? Till you answer, I'm not going to go for the next step here. What are the left elements that you see here? 98 23 45 40. See, get my questions, or you're not able to get any questions here? I think there is some delay happening, right? Okay, you're getting. Okay, I'm sorry. I was not getting. So, what are the left elements in the divided list? Can anyone answer me? What are the left elements in the divided list? Yes, great. Just hold for a minute. Now, if you see your pseudocode, let me go back once again to the pseudocode. Now, here if you see the pseudocode, here if you see, till now we did this point. Till now we have finished this, right? Till now we have done this. After that, what I am doing is merge sort on left. This step I am going to explain you for a minute. Okay? Till now. So, which element is my merge sort is to be done again? After this, which step is my merge sort to be done again? Yeah, left elements. So now I continue. See here. Correct? Yes, only on left elements. Now, since again, recursively, I will perform the division on again left elements. If you see, I will not move to right until my all left elements are actually merged. Till here I have done? Yes or no? Till here my left is going to done. Yes. Now what is the next? Now merging of left right will be done. See here. Now I will be merging them. Left is 98, 23. Is it merged done? Is this my final list? No. Again I will work on the right. If you see, next is working on 45, 14. Now merge. Got it? Now again I will merge these two, because both left and right are done. Now I will be again merging. Then you got this recursion, how it is happening? Any questions do you have? How is this happening? Okay. Yeah, I could see that here. There is a delay happening, but now you got the answer how it is. So if you see, all the left is done, now we will go to the, so recursive. So till now here if you see, the process is paused here till, because right merge sort has to work on. So now again we will continue this, right, and we will perform the merge. Sorry, just 1 second, that was okay, right? And now at the end we did the if you see, this is now what we did for the final. Now I think after this step I don't need to explain. After this step, do you think I need to explain anything? No, so just we'll go to the final for your sake. Sorry, I can't. Now you know how the merging has happened. Got it? Now how the merge sort has got. Now anyone can say, yes, same process is right. Now can someone say what is the total time complexity of this algorithm takes place? Is order of n log n. Perfect. Now can anyone, since you have worked on your midterm exam, can anyone give me what will be the recursive equation for this? Yes, merge also happens recursive because again you have uncompleted sorted list, so it will be repeated. Okay? Yes, it's a bottom of fashion. Yes. Correct, Divya. You are correct. Okay. Now can anyone come up with what is the time complexity for this whole step? The first step. Someone has given me the answer, that's pretty good. Okay, let's see whether your answers are correct or not. So what is the time taken for the first operation, that is this operation? Constant time? Because I'm just finding, yes, constant, perfect, constant. Now what about the copying operation, yeah? The for loop which is used to copy. What is the time complexity for this? Answer is correct, Anirudh. Constant, Monica, your answer is correct. Constant time for copying, but how many times I am repeating this constant copying operation? N times, no? Will you say this is constant into N? Correct? Yeah, N constant, Monica, you are correct. So I just wanted to write now. Okay. What is the time taken for the sort on left? This, how much time do I take? N or N by 2, all the elements I am working or half of the elements only I am working? Yes. Don't say order, just say N by 2. Time of N by 2, correct. Right? N by 2. Now I told you merge sort already has taken equation of order of N. So some operation like this, I can just say it would have taken Cn plus some constant operations plus some constant amount, right? Can I say this as the equation? Because it's order of n, right? Merging of left right array is n operation, right? Can I give you this equation? Yes. Okay. If you do the complete match, can I say the time complexity of this is, if I have got one element, will my algorithm run or not? Last one, Divya, the last step is, sorry, type error, correct. Sorry. Correct? The last step, if you see, it's only merge left right of you. I'm sorry, I have wrote merge, so it's merge, right? I'm sorry, that was a typo error. Got it? Thank you. Thanks, Divya, for correcting me. Now, if I do not have any elements, I have got one element, it's a constant time output. If I have got greater than 2, the equation is 2t n by 2 plus n. Can I say this as equation? If you do addition of this whole equation, you will get that as an answer. Can you do that? It will be actually 2t n by 2 plus c n into c2 plus c3 plus c1 plus c4. Yes. Is it in the form of master theorem or not yet? Is it in the form of master theorem? Yeah. Which master theorem will you use for this? You have freedom, quickly go through and answer. Case 2. Pawan, I think you have worked really hard for the midterm, man. You are answering almost all questions. Right? So it's the case 2. So what is the final output that you are going to get is? Order of n log n. You got it? Merge sort is order of n log n. Now if you want to use a recursive method, I have already given it. So you can just work on it. Case 2 of simple master theorem. You don't need to use the master theorem advanced version. So I am clear for it, or do you have any questions on master theorem? Now I understood how to make this class more interactive. So both the systems should be logged in so that I can see your chat boxes and I can write using my iPad so that there is no distraction. Right? Great. So next class onwards we'll have more and more interact so that I don't need to come out of the recording mode. Good. So any other questions? Regarding merge sort, do you have any questions? So if you have understood, can anyone do this as homework? Yeah, so try to do this as homework, and we will have this discussed in the next session. So can I move to the quick sort, or do you have any questions, please? I hope my merge sort is clear now. Yeah, we can go to the quick sort, right? Great. Can I go? Yeah, you know, this is just homework so that you have understood. See, do the way how the PPTs are done. Like, finish the left first, then go to right, okay? Okay, so that, and also work on the pseudocode. Okay, so let me go to quick sort for a minute. Okay. Okay, so I'm working on quicksort again. That's the next topic that we are supposed to discuss. See, after quicksort, we will not cover bucket sorting in this session. We will cover the bucket sorting at the end. So one of the sorting will be given as self-learn kind of thing that I'll let you know in the next session, which algorithm you have to learn and which will be covered. Okay, now let's talk about quicksort. So people are clear about divide and conquer techniques, they have understood recursion. Is that clear? So everyone is clear with that? Yeah. Okay. See, in quicksort, we will also use divide and conquer technique, but the division that we are going to do here is using something called as pivot value. Okay? Okay. We will use something called as pivot value. Yeah, Ram, the final time complexity for merge sort is theta of n log n. So someone has answered me the time complexity as VO. See, if you use master theorem case 2, it is theta of n log n. Okay? Okay. Now, I just before going to quicksort, I will just compare between merge and quicksort. What is the time complexity of merge sort that I have discussed is theta of n log n, which means it's an average case. Do you agree with that? It's an average case? Yeah. Okay. Now the biggest problem to go to worst case is always given a list as sorted. Okay, that's a different case. We will not have, we don't need to worry on that too much. But the reason why the, in both merge sort and quick sort, sorted list is order of n square. But most of the time merge sort runs in average case. The biggest problem with what has merge sort is the memory. It needs always an extra space of memory. That's why I told you the time complexity or the, sorry, the space complexity of merge sort is order of n or order of n log n. Why these two time complex? See, when we are talking about space complex, sorry, I gave you two. If I would say order of n, you would have agreed. But I said it's order of n and order of n log n. Which is greater? Order of n is greater or order of n log n is greater in the time complex, space complexity? If my order of n log n is larger, what happens is the algorithm that we use, because we are not cleaning up the extra or auxiliary array spaces, then the time complexity, the space complexity is order of n log n. If you are cleaning up the auxiliary, then your space complexity is order of n. You understood that why the space complexity of merge sort is order of n log n? Or order of n. Now is that clear? I just forgot to say you at the end. Right, hopefully you would have been partially clear. Okay, as you read again, you'll understand it much clear. Okay, now quicksort is the most popular algorithm which even has the worst case time complexity of order of n square and average case time complexity of order of n log n. Now I have mentioned here it is a worst case situation exists for it, but still it is popular. All the sorting techniques that whatever you get as pre-installed are all written in quicksort. See, if you are working on a portable devices which has got memory issues, you cannot run merge sort because merge sort requires extra space. Whereas quicksort is, by this time you should have understood, quicksort is an in-place algorithm or not? When I told about it's more popular and it is used as portable, it's mostly used in portable devices, right? Yes, it's an in-place algorithm. That's why the quicksort is more familiar. Now, one more question. Quicksort has a worst time complexity of order of n squared. When this situation comes, we'll discuss later, but the best average time case is always order of n log n. We'll see first an example which always deals with order of n log n and the worst case time complexity of order of n squared. See, how many people remember our intro class here? The first introduction class. Does people remember our introduction class? Yeah. When we are discussing about algorithms, that is sorting algorithm, have you come across a word called randomized quicksort? Randomized quicksort, have you come, have you remembered yet? Yeah, you would have seen in the notes or you would have seen in the first slide, there was, I was doing that. So quicksort, what people say is quicksort always gives you average time complexity as order of n log n. It means it's a random, it's that we will see at the end, okay? Yeah, choosing the pivot value randomly. That will not worry because a lot of people might not even recollect what is pivot value. It's been so many years, but a lot of people, okay. Now I have to sort this element. What was the technique that I have used in merge sort? If I have got a list, I have to divide, right? Did I divide it or not in merge sort? Yeah, how did I divide it in merge sort? If you can recollect quickly, how does the division of the list happen? Mid value, right? If I do mid value division here, which algorithm will I use? If I do n by 2 here, which algorithm it is going? Merge sort, right? So quick sort doesn't use something called division of n by 2. It divides the list cleverly. Okay, I have one more question for you. In merge sort, when you did n by 2 division, what were the elements on the left and what were the elements on the right? How are the elements on the left and how are the elements on the right? Are sorted or unsorted first? Unsorted. Good. First answer is unsorted. Next. Were all these elements less than the mid value or greater than the mid value? They were random. There were no condition of less than elements or greater than elements, right? Not necessary, John, you are correct. But you have seen no elements in a less than condition or greater. Just elements left side and just left elements right side. That's all you have seen. Quicksort, when we are using this dividing option, what quicksort does is, when you are dividing the list into two halves, it takes care of one situation, that is all the elements in the left side should be smaller than the divided value and all the elements that are on the right side of the divided element or divided value should be greater than the mid value element. How do I achieve this? So I have watched something different now for you. The quick sort, when you do division, the left side elements should be smaller than it and all the right side elements should be greater than it somehow. So that is a big important question, that is called as partitioning of the list of elements. So first we will not work on the partition, we will work first on the quicksort. Okay. So what is the first step, most important step is selection of value, that is called as the pivot value selection. Okay. So to do partition, I should select a value, right? Yes. Which the value that generally we choose as pivot is either the first value or the last value. Okay, any of the first value or the last value can be chosen as a pivot value. So in my example, I'll be choosing the last value, which is none other than 4. Okay, what is my pivot value now? Yeah, my pivot value is 4. Now with the help of 4, I should bring 4 into such a position that 4 is going to divide my list, it is going to do partition of my list such that all the values less than 4 are on the left side and all the values greater than 4 are on right side. What does it mean? Can anyone make a guess? If I am bringing an element into division position and I am saying all the elements that are on its left side and all the elements that are on right side are greater, then what is the position of 4? Can I say 4 is a sorted position? 4 is in its correct position? Yes, so that's why we use a pivot value. Here, the recursion operation is always selection of pivot. Now, Moni, you have a very good question. Do the elements on the left side should be 1, 2, 3, 4? No. Let's say somehow I did the division here. Somehow, let's take I did the division. Now, let's say 4 is the value which is dividing. Now, what are the elements that should be on the left side? Can you say me what are the elements on the left side? What are the elements that are on to the left side? 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 3. Okay, Anirudh, finish your answer. 4, wait. Ranjan, 5 kaisa aa gaya yaar? 5 is greater than 4, right? Yeah. 3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 2. Okay, that's perfect. 4 already in its position, no? 4 is in its position. Right side elements, can anyone say right side elements? I got these are answer, left element. Because 4 is the dividing element, right side. 7, 6, 8, 5. Okay. Then, any other answers? 7, 6, 8, 5 I have written. Any, okay. 8, 7, 6, 5. 6, 7, 8, 5. And one more thing I have is 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. That's enough. Now, when you have given me these answers, I would like to add one more point. That the elements that are on the left side need not to be in a sorted order. Just one condition we are seeing is elements less than, elements greater than. That's the main condition. You may have end up with getting 1, 3, 2. Luckily, you might end up getting 1, 2, 3. You might get up as 3, 2, 1. Anything is fine. But it doesn't matter. What it matters is the pivot value in its correct position. That's all. This is the important thing that matters for us. So right side, I can have any of this order. So what it only pivot value that is being used as dividing of the list, we are going to get it in its appropriate position. Right? So let's see. Okay. So pivot value selection, I have told you the value that I'm going to select as pivot value is 4, right? Which is my last value. Now somehow I got my pivot value in its correct position. Is that the correct position? Is it the correct position of the pivot value? No. Somehow I bought. Somehow. See, this bringing of the pivot value to its correct position is called as partition. Remember here, I have not taught you how the partition is done. I just told I have bought the pivot value. Okay. Now, pivot is in its correct position, yes or no? Is the pivot in its correct position? Yes. If I repeat the same process on the unsorted list, what will I get finally? Can you say me? What will I get finally? Now, if I repeat left, if I do the same repetition on the left element, if I do the same repetition on right element, at the end, what will happen to all the pivot values are in its appropriate position, yes or no? Yeah. If from single value, if I backtrack to all the pivot values, what will I get? Will I get a sorted list? Yes. So that's what we are doing using a pivot value. Now this is what it happened. Now you can see. Now again, I recursively choose my pivot value on 3. Okay. And I continue. One second. Yes, this is what we did now. So again, recursively do. This is what we have done till now. Can anyone say, is this what I can do recursively? One second here. I think you are getting a small delay. I'm showing you that. Yeah. I think now it's fine. Yeah. Now this is fine. What I did on one side of recursion. Yeah. No, that's what I told you, right? Pavan, I'm actually seeing the live stream also separately so that I can just answer your question. Now is this what I did recursively? What is that? Can I write the pseudocode for a minute? For this portion, do you want me to write pseudocode for this? Okay. Let me write the pseudocode. Okay. So I'm applying the quicksort on complete array start from end. Did you see? I'm applying the quicksort from start for end next. Okay. Now. So, p index is the partition value. Okay. P index is the value. Here, what is the p index? Can anyone say me in the first step? No. Okay. One of Anirudh. Here if you see, you have a question. Alright, sorry. If here you see, I have not choose as first element here. Here also I have done and bought it to the friend. Okay? It's not 1, 2. If you see after choosing pivot, the list is 2, 1 and 1 was chosen as pivot and pivot was bought in its appropriate position. So it had, so if you want me to add this intermediate steps, something like the list was 2, 1 and pivot value was chosen as 1. After the swap step, the partition step, we got this. So I just, for the space sake, I just removed that step. Okay? Now is that clear? Okay. Great. Now, what I am doing is, I am choosing a value which is called T index that is going to partition my list from A star to AN, right? Okay. After that, what I did, if you clearly see here, I applied quicksort. Here I applied the quicksort. Yes or no? Yeah. So again, same quicksort I am going to apply here or not to get my answers? Yes. So that's what is my simple pseudocode that I have written till now. Okay. Now what is the important point I am missing here? Can anyone say? What is the important point here that you see? Identifying of partition. If you see partition itself, how do I am identifying partition? How I am bringing the partition into its appropriate position itself is an algorithm, right? So that algorithm we will discuss. Before that, if this to run this, what is the base condition that you will have? If I have to run a quick sort, how many elements should my array contain? At least how many elements should my array contain? Greater than 1. That's my base case. Okay? So that's a better way to write. If start is less than n, then only I will be applying my quick sort, right? What if start value is 0 and n value is 7, I can apply the quick sort. If start is less than, if not less than n, it means to say that both start and end are equal. If someone can wants to write start equal to n, it's okay. But this case will take care more carefully the auxiliary values. Is this clear? Is this clear till now? Yeah. Any questions? Did we get any big rocket science till this point? No. The major algorithm is involved at which portion here? Yeah? Is it at the partition portion? Do you want me to finish the partition today or in the next session, that is after the midterm? Because we have got only 10 minutes. I don't know whether I will be able to finish it in the 10 minutes or not. Next session. Yeah, next time. Okay, great. So before going to finish this session, I will have a certain question. So you need to help me out. So next session, we will have two topics, that is, one is quicksort and the next one is introduction to graphs. Is that okay? Yeah. Okay. So next session, we'll have quicksort and as well as we'll have introduction to graph. Okay. Next question. So someone had asked me, how are pivot values choose? Remember, in quicksort, the pivot value can be the last element in the list or the first element in the list. Any case. Someone can say, can't I choose, instead of 4, can I choose something like, let me go back once again. Sorry. We have to go back to the unsorted list, right? Sorry. One second, list. Yeah, graphs you will enjoy, don't worry. I will take care. Now I have worked on this much because only for making sure how can I write on iPad and so that it is more clearly projecting to you. Right? So someone can even choose 7 as pivot value. That is not at all an issue. No, you don't have any lectures here. After midterm exam only we have lecture. So 13, 14 we don't have any exams. We do not have any lectures. Pavan, what I did is, see in this session, the mistake I did is, actually I was using only the iPad so that I could have written it clear. Now I understood, if I am also logging in both, the system and iPad, I am actually to deliver. So in system I am able to see your questions and I am not stopping the recording. In the previous case I have to stop the record, come back and have to read your chat box and go back. That was a lot of breaking, right? So this I have figured it out. So first I log into the iPad and start the recording, then I simultaneously log into the desktop so that I can see your chat box. So I'll not miss any chat, yes, don't worry. See, I feel very bad if I miss some chats because I am going out, my questions are missing. See, I feel more alive when you ask me questions, right? Okay, any other questions regarding today's first thought and quick thought, that is only division portion. Okay, so your sessions will be more interactive because I wanted to write it more. So I think the writing is okay. Do you want me to improve? I know I have scrambled it at few points, but at least markings are, those things are coming clear. Okay, great. Okay, any other questions do you have regarding your midterm and anything? That's fine. I'll be open. See, solution to midterm will be only given after 15. So 15, 16, someday I'll upload all the makeup and regular exam with. Apart from that, one more question, was there any other type of errors that you have encountered? Nitesh, what I will do is, Master Theorem I will record separately here. I will record and upload. If still you have issues, we will discuss, right? Okay. With quick sort, but first look, it looks like taking some time as, say, yes, quick sort will take the same time as merge sort, but it will never go to its worst case. That is order of n squared. But merge sort can go to. That's what we will discuss when we are talking. Okay. Except NP for no, that I have announced here. After that, do this. Don't worry here. If I am not us, just forget it. If I am not us, forget it. Okay, we will see how you have written. Okay, there are questions on stack. I did not understand. Okay, so the question on stack, what I have asked you is, you do not have session on the next week. That is when there are makeup exam. After makeup exam, we will have the session. The stack question, what I have asked you is, how are you going to implement multiple stacks on a single array? So this question I will give you. You will enjoy this question. Don't worry. The answer to this question. That is only the toughest question, I think, throughout the question bank. Full binary tree question. What was that full binary tree question, Pavan? I am not able to recollect. There was an issue in the given problem. One mentioned as a full binary and there was... Oh, okay. Okay. That question. See, that is, I wanted you to come up with a formula. How many nodes? Okay, that I'll see. 100 nodes. No, if you have been given 100 nodes, got it. It's possible, don't worry. that's an easy, you have to go. I will give you the solution. Look at the solution and still you can. We'll see. Okay, that's what you. So, can I consider my paper as 50% easy? Or 50% you enjoyed it and 50% you cursed me? 50% I think at least 30. Okay, 30 is easy, Pawan. Okay, there are two Pawan. Sorry, Pawan. Okay, thanks. So, makeup will be also somewhat similar here. Don't worry. Whoever attempting makeup, you will not. Okay, so you enjoyed it now. So, my papers, I try to make sure that you enjoy. Are, Master Theorem, BSC and AML, if you see, there are more questions on that. Okay. So let me end up the session for today. We'll meet on the next session. Let me say the date. When is the next session also? One second, just give me. So next session, let me just check and let me answer your question. Next session is, one second, yeah. So our next session will be mostly after Dasara. So 20 and 21st we might have session. No session tomorrow. So no session, we do not have any more session till the midterm is done. So all the best for those guys who are actually attending the midterm. Chalo, Mila. So I am ending up the presentation. Okay. Right. So I am ending the session also. So wish you all the best and